Hello, welcome to this lesson about browser-defined functions. So the browser has some predefined functions that we can use to achieve a lot of different things. For instance, we can print a web page, or we can navigate to a different URL, or we can fetch some data from an API. And if you want to know what is all possible, then you can use MDN to find out, and I'll show you now. So first, let's see what methods are there. Let's say we want to print this web page. Well, it's really easy. We can just type window print, and it is a method. So we have to call it as a method with these parentheses, and then the browser will try to print the page. Well, I don't want to really print it. It's a waste of paper. So let's cancel that. And now let's see if we can actually navigate to a different page. So a browser has a window, and then in the window it has a location, and that location has an href, which is a difficult word for URL or address. So we can say, hey, just make that a key future, and I want to find out how to actually do this. Well, let's do it like that with the mouse, and then we navigate the website to Hack Your Future. Well, let us go back to safety and clear this all up. And let's see if we can fetch some data. And I found a nice API that provides all the information about the solar system, and we can ask it for some information about my favorite planet. See, I've already typed it before. So we do window.fetch. It's a method that's on window that will do an HTTP request to this URL, and let's see what happens. So, well, we get a promise. And that's JavaScript telling us, hey, I'm doing something, and at some point in the future, I'll be done. And we'll learn all about that in a later lesson of JavaScript 2. So for now, let's see what has happened in the browser tab, or in the network tab of the browser. So we can see here that there's been requests to this endpoint, or this URL with Mars, and let's see what it came back with. See what the response was. So we got some nice data about Mars. Its name, its moons, it's a lot of technical data, the gravity. So on Earth we have 9.81, on Mars it's a fair bit lower, so you could jump pretty high probably on Mars. So yeah, some nice data about this planet. And well, so those are three examples of browser-defined functions, and you probably want to learn what is possible, because a lot is possible. And if you want to find out, then the best place to do that is on MDN. And basically, you want to go to the page about window. Oh, I'm sorry. So, well, this will show you how I got here. I type window and then MDN, and then the first hit is this page. And well, here it will write everything about what window contains and what it offers you. So it has the document that we talked about in the previous video, but it also has a history API. So let's say that's an interesting one. It has the navigator, which is, I don't know, what's the window.navigator? What is this? About application running the script. So this is basically some information about the browser. Okay, interesting. And let's see, and then we have location. Well, that's what we used, location.href to change. location. Let's see how they do it here. Navigate to a new page. They don't use the href. Well, that's how I remember how to do it. So there's even something for me to learn here. Well, that's where I would look if I needed some information. And that concludes this lesson on the browser-defined functions. And good luck.